Welcome back to my channel. My name is Vicky and I am a mommy YouTuber. I make videos from Lagos, Nigeria. Guys, I just picked up my camera to just talk about this thing because for the longest time lately, I have actually been feeling really, really bored, like bored. And I felt like, okay, this is mostly as a result of the fact that I am married, like not like because of the fact that I'm married, but I live this kind of sedentary life that I actually don't have friends. I don't have, like, I don't know how to explain my kind of lifestyle. I don't know how to explain how things are, but I just felt like, let me come on here and talk to you guys about why I regret getting married, or should I use the word disadvantage, or why I regret anyone, but these are just the reason why I really feel like I regret getting married. But for the record purpose, I am happily married, just so you don't think that I am having some issue or the other. So guys, without further ado, let us dive right into this video. Guys, number one reason why I literally regret why I am married is the fact that there is no more I but we. You get is a situation whereby from the very first day you get married, you cannot talk about yourself alone. You cannot do things based on by yourself anymore. You have to take permission, or you have to talk about it with your spouse. You have to, like, this is, I'm sure this is not just me alone in this situation, as in the case of marriage. You understand, the minute you marry and you want your marriage to be successful, I'm sure you have to drop this I mentality and embrace the we mentality, because everything you do has to be talked about, has to be discussed. Any decision you take has to be we kind of decision, has to be able to fit in your spouse and even your children. You understand, anything you do. So your I mentality, your selfish mentality, your self-centered mentality has to drop. And sometimes you just want to be alone, you just want to do things on your own, you just want to take a decision by yourself, you just want to, you know, just be you, like be Vicky and not just Mrs. somebody or mom, somebody's mommy or daddy. But that is really not happening anymore. And then the number two reason why I will say I regret getting married is that I lost all my single friends. Yeah. I don't know why it's like that, because I don't want to say the fault is from me. My very best friend who is still single, and before I got married, we stopped being friends for no reason. I really do not know why. And a few of my friends, maybe not really, really close friends, but people we normally talk to, or you can call, they're my friend or something like that, that are single, we just realized that we drifted apart, not because of anything, but maybe because our ideas or what we think about or what we want to do is different. You know, normally when you're single, you can just be, let's go hang out, oh, let's go chill out, or oh, let's do this, let's do that. And then for some reason, as the fact that you are married and you are accountable to somebody, based on the first reason I'm talking about, you cannot just go out and come back when you like, or you cannot just do things the way your single friends do their things. You understand, because they are accountable to themselves and to no one else. And you realize that for some reason you guys are just drifting apart for no, just as in, I don't know, that thing, just that space just keeps coming slowly. Because if you do not make a conscious effort of trying to make that relationship or that friendship still close like this, I'm very sure, due to the fact that you're married, or due to the fact that I am married, we actually drifted apart and that was it. And now Vicky is now friendless. And then you guys, you know, but three reasons why I really regret getting married is, almost there is no more free time. Like, you do not have any free time again. You do not have that time to go and chill out and have some drinks. You do not have that free time to, in fact, the fact that you are married and you were still, you now have children, let me not use the word worst, but you now have children, you understand, you just lack that me time. In fact, sometimes you literally want to hide in the toilet to even eat biscuits. You literally want to hide in the toilet to press your phone a little, just to have that private time. You understand, there is no time to go to have personal time. because you'll be thinking of the kids. You have to be thinking of your husband, as in no free time, because at the end of the day, you wake up in the morning, you prepare the kids for school, and before you know it, you're already thinking of lunch, especially for the fact that you are like somebody like me that stays at home and works from home, you understand? So you just see that you don't even have time for yourself, because the time you might have for yourself on a normal day, if you're single, you can eat out, you understand? But when you have a husband and children, you're just thinking of what they eat. Even if you have meal in the freezer or food prepared and stored in the freezer, you just see that your life is so busy. Even if you are thinking of even if you're trying to create space for yourself, your head is still busy doing one thing or the other. Guys, marriage makes your life so busy. No free time, because I know when I was single, you see me, you can at least sleep, chill, press your phone, nobody's disturbing you, nobody's calling you for one thing or the other, nobody's looking for your attention. But now when you have little humans to just cater for, you know, some little humans are depending on you for survival, like their lives are hanging on yours, like hanging on your existence at the very moment, you understand? You just realize that you don't even have time to breathe, like you have to be on your toes. Like, I really don't know how to explain it. And then another reason why I feel I regret getting married is, well, this is nice. The fact that I'm married is nice, but what would it have been? You know, that thought of thinking of, oh, what would my life had been if I wasn't married, especially with somebody like me that got married earlier. I got married in my early 20s, and you're just thinking that what would life had been without, if I had not gotten married when I got married, if what would I be doing by this age? What would I have been doing by this stage? Would I have gotten something better? Would I have done something better? In as much as right now you feel like, I feel like my marriage is so good, or I do not regret my partner, but you know that human mentality where you'd be like, which choice would I have made, or how would my life have been? How have I used hammer? Based on the fact that, you know, when you are single, you have so many anticipation, you had so many desires, you've had so many plans, you've been thinking of what you will do, and then now you're married, it just seems as if some of the plans were thwarted, or were narrowed down, or were adjusted, and then you're feeling like, and then I'm feeling like, so you guys just understand what I'm trying to say, and then I'm feeling like, God, how would my life have been if I was not married, you understand? What would have become of me? What would I have done? Would I have done something? Would I have been better? Would I have been greater? But at the end of the day, we are humans. We sometimes want to see what, like, have a taste of things, or we sometimes want to see things in another way, testing in another way, or something like that. We are just human, and I feel like it's just me being human. And then the last but not the least, guys, I didn't want to make this video long. I just felt like, let me come gist with you guys. Why I regret getting married is the fact that I have to deal with in-laws. Like, yeah, even though my in-laws are not troublesome to me, but the fact that, you know, that situation whereby if you have issues with your in-law, for instance, you have issue with your sister-in-law, you have issue with your brother-in-law, or you have issue with your mother-in-law, the fact that if they were your brother, like your blood brother, like for instance, if I have issue with my brother or my sister or my mom or my dad, oh, we go change them for each other. You know, when you can at least express yourself to your mom, you can express yourself to your dad, even if you're angry, in as much as you still maintain the respect, but you're able to express yourself even in anger to them. But the fact that they are in-laws, you just sometimes just be like, I respect myself. I don't want change and fun, that kind of thing. You understand? You have to just deal with them. You have to swallow a lot of things just so you do not cross the line, or just so you people live in peace, or just so you people live happily. But this is just part of, well, one of the reasons why I just felt like, for no marry you. You understand, that kind of a thing. But all in all, I still thank God that I am married. I thank God for where I am. I thank God for how far He has brought me. It's been the grace of God. I thank God for my choice of partner. God just helped me to, you know, choose the right person and all that. I'm just grateful for where I am. But these are just some of the ojukokoro. One is just thinking and making one feel like, I for not marry, or I for marry, or something like that. Well, marriage is a sweet thing if most definitely you choose the right person. Anyway, guys, what are your regrets? For those of you who are watching me and feel like, okay, I have one or two regrets of getting married, mine is not in a negative light, you understand? But what are those things you think in your heart and be like, ah, if I wasn't married, this would have happened. If I wasn't married, this would have happened, and all that and all that. Please leave it in the comment section. Do you have any regrets of getting married? Do you regret, I regret getting married, whether negatively or positively? Let us continue this gist in the comment section. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please, if you did, give it a thumbs up, leave me a comment in the comment section, and please, please, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't subscribed. And wait, turn on your notification bell so that YouTube will inform you whenever I post a new video. And thanks very much for watching. I will most definitely see you guys in my next video. Bye bye, guys.